wasn't bad at all.
That was easy. Hey, folks, how y'all doing? Welcome to another little episode of Real Country with Jeff and Melanie. On this one, I got Miss Melanie behind the camera. Yeah, there we go.
Hey, y'all.
Today, as been the case most of the week, you can't tell in one way, but it's been raining off and on all week. Last weekend, and it's supposed to rain the rest of this week. So we've got to do what we can when we can. And it's already muggying up, getting ready to rain. But I thought, why it's dry temporarily, I'm behind on cutting my firewood for this winter. So I figured I'd get out here today and cut the tree down. And then I've got some other things we're going to do, but I'm going to come back in the next day or two, weather permitting, and we're going to try to cut it up and then move it, and then when I can, split it, stack it, and let it be drying. As hot as our summers are, I believe by the time we get cold weather, this wood will be good to burn. Usually anywhere from 4 to 6 months, it's ready to go. And as hot as we've been, it's already been in the hundreds for several weeks. I don't think we'll have any trouble with this drying out and having us a good little mess of firewood. Now, we don't heat right now for our heating. But we run our fireplace to enjoy a fire. But this will give us enough. And I've got another tree that's already down that I cut a while back. Between the two of them, that may be all I need. But in case, you know, everything permits, if I have to, I can get out here and lay another one. We got some little crooked that we need to thin out. But I believe we'll have enough firewood to last us for a while. But let's see, I may go cut a few limbs off. I don't think there's no real big limbs on this tree. But I'll cut some limbs off now while I can, and then we'll probably cut it in sections next day or two. But stick with us, and we'll cut a few, and then we'll head up and get involved in something else in just a few minutes.
Yeah.
I think that's going to be my stopping point for right now. If I can get my camera person to look right in there real good, and then follow this tree over, just turn around. Oh, let me take it. There we go. Right here, when this tree fell down, it actually caught the top of another tree. And if you'll follow that arch, we got a slingshot bent over. See there? That's ready to spring up. And I'm gonna have to do some careful clipping in here. As I was pruning these tops, I could feel that tree wanting to whoop up. And I don't want to get whooped in the face with it. So I think for right now, kind of looks like we got a cloud fixing to thunder up. I'm gonna just let this sit this evening and let it spring by itself. If not, I'll come back tomorrow and I'll carefully prune it out and clear this underneath out of the way that I cut up some. And that way, hopefully, even if it does spring on me, my camera lady may not be out here, and we don't want to take a chance of an accident, somebody getting a tree branch in the face. But I'll pass the camera back real quick. Let me scoot back a little bit. But if she'll pan down, just the little limbs is a pretty good little pile of wood right there. Like I said, I try to cut them just roughly 12 to 16 inches. They'll fit in the fireplace real good. And we try not to waste any of the tree. Even the small branches, I'll come back with snips and snip them up and make kindling out of them. And try to use as much of it. Ain't no sense in it spending its lifetime growing. And then I just let it pile up and rot. But that'll be all the cutting we're going to do for today. I'm about ready for a sip of water. But we'll head on back up, see what other trouble we can get into. Stick with us. All right, folks, as you can tell, we're running behind. This is our 4th of July watermelon. We had so much to eat on the 4th of July, we didn't have room for it. So, Miss Melanie don't really care for watermelon, but I like a little bit of it. So I'm going to eat a little bit, and then we're going to have a little treat. We're going to slice it up and let the chickens have fun pecking. But let's see if I can cut it with my old butcher knife. Let's see. Haven't done this in a while. When I was a boy, we had a garden that was away from our house at our little farm. And we ate watermelon once they got ready, about all summer long. Oh yeah, that's pretty. Look at that. That's pretty. And I'm just going to cut me a little bit right now. My uncle, we'd ride out there in his truck, and he always kept a big old aluminum salt shaker on the dash of his pickup truck just for our watermelon. And now, that's about the only thing I add salt to anymore. Cutting again. I can do it without cutting my hand. That old rhyme's tough. There we go. But it ain't summertime if you don't have a little bit of watermelon, even if you are running late. That's pretty. And now put a little bit of salt on it. That just makes it more butter, as they used to say. And let's see how good that is. That's good.
Gotta spit a seed out now.
Hadn't hit one yet. Wait, a few in there.
This one doesn't have a whole lot in this portion. Yeah, when I was a boy, we'd go out to our garden in the evening in the summertime after my dad and my uncle got off work. And we'd get two little small ones like this, and we'd pull them, thump them, make sure that they're ripe. And then we'd break the kernel off, go set them in the shade. Before we came home, we'd go get salt shaker off my uncle's dash of his truck. And we'd just pick them up, bust them on the ground, and break them into pieces and eat the center out, and then go throw them in the hog pen, let the hogs have them. That's good, but the salt sets it off. And you ain't lived till it's 100 degrees in the shade, and you sitting out eating, about like I'm doing now, with watermelon juice running down your arm, running down your chin, you're hot and sweaty, got dust and dirt from hoeing in the field. It wasn't cold back then, but it was good. And a little bit of salt goes a long way.
They say that watermelon's a diuretic.
Yeah, watermelon's good for you if you eat it. Got to eat a bunch of it.
Right.
Then you get your salt shaker and you cheat a little bit more. Like I said, it may look like I'm putting a lot on this. Miss Melanie can tell you, we quit adding salt to about everything years ago. I don't even put it on popcorn anymore.
No.
So, a little bit ain't going to hurt every now and then. And in just a minute, we're going to slice it up, and then we'll show you feeding the chickens. Let them have fun picking out. But for right now, I'll let y'all ease on, and I'm going to finish a little bit of this watermelon. Wish you were here.
Okay, so there's a piece of watermelon that Jeff threw in there for the chickens. At first, they just stood there looking at it. They were like, what is that? But it didn't take them long to figure out, oh, I can eat it.
Slide another one
in here. He's cut up another one to put in there. They're like,
Here's something never before seen on TV. Bunch of chickens and one turkey eating some watermelon.
Say gobble gobble. I thought he was saying he's gonna go give it to our turkeys, but I guess not.
I told you I like it.
Have you spit a seed out yet?
Have I what now?
Spit a seed.
I haven't hit but one. I did off camera.
Off camera. Okay.
Nobody won't see me go.
That's fine. Yeah. As long as you got one, that makes it official that you ate watermelon.
That's right. There's not a whole lot in this melon.
There's not.
They saw the turkey already. They're going to town with that.
They're starting to... Those other two pieces you put in there, it took them a minute or two to figure out, that's the same thing.
It's good for them. They like it. It won't hurt anything. Now, you wouldn't want to give it to them all the time. But, like I said, part of one watermelon ain't going to affect them. It won't hurt them a bit. Oh. Alrighty, folks. That's gonna wrap it up for today. Thank y'all for watching. Hope you enjoy. Until next time, good Lord willing, the creek don't rise. We'll see you down the road. Thank you.